I'm Zach Rude, chef partner at Coastal Kitchen and Daiquiri Bar in Bayshore, New York. And today I'm gonna show you how we make our roasted garlic Chardonnay butter mussels. First thing we do, start with some really nice fresh mussels. Put them in a pan. We're gonna add a little bit of our homemade lobster stock to that to give it a really nice oceany seafood flavor. If you don't have lobster stock, you could use chicken stock, clam juice, you know, anything like that you like. Really, I just like the lobster stock because it really drives home the seafood flavor. A little bit of Chardonnay in the pan. And with that, we put a little bit of unsalted sweet cream butter, good quality. That really helps the viscosity and the texture of the broth when you cook the finished product. You can use as much or as little as you like, you know, totally up to preference. When we actually cook the mussels, we're gonna flavor it with a couple other things. Here we have our garlic confit. It's a slow roasted garlic that we cooked submerged in olive oil for about 7 hours at 250 degrees. Makes it really soft, sweet, tender, really delicious. Here we have some hot Thai basil. Little different than traditional basil. It's got a little more of anise and some almost like cinnamon notes to it, a little bit of spice. Really elevates the dish quite a bit. And just some fresh lemon, because the acidity in the mussels really just ties everything together and really brings out the flavor of the mussels. And to finish that, we serve it with our homemade French fries that we use equal parts potato and yuca to make it a little more interesting, that we fry with some fresh herbs to really coat the fries. All right, now that we have everything ready, we're gonna go over the range and cook some mussels. All right, first thing you wanna do is get a really hot pan. It's key that your pan's really hot because you want the mussels to open as soon as possible just so they stay nice and plump and don't get shriveled up. The mussels we're using here today are from Prince Edward Island. All the really good mussels you use are from Maine or Prince Edward Island because the really cold water helps them stay really salty and briny. So I'm gonna start with the roasted garlic oil that we cooked the garlic in. Gives it a really nice garlicky flavor. If you don't have garlic oil, you could use olive oil, canola oil, you know, whatever you really like to cook with at home. First thing we're gonna add is that garlic confit, the roasted garlic that we used earlier. Hear that sizzle, that's good, that's what you want. We're gonna let that go for about 15, 20 seconds, get really, really hot. All right, you're good there. Take the pan you built earlier with the white wine, the lobster stock, and the butter. Cover it up, keep it capped. You wanna keep it covered because it really helps intensify the steam, which again helps them pop open quickly as possible, which gives you a really plump, juicy mussel as opposed to the shriveled up ones that you see a lot of places. Hit it with a little bit of kosher salt. Give it another 30 seconds or so and we'll be ready to go. Gonna add my fresh herbs at this point. You wanna add those towards the end because you don't want them to get nice and brown. Squeeze some fresh lemon, because again, you have to have lemon with mussels. You always wanna give them a taste before you serve them. Oh yeah, that's delicious. Beautiful. You wanna arrange them all nice. You can show off those beautiful plump mussels that you have there. So this is how the mussels come to the table. We bring them with our house fried fries that are, again, potato, yuca, fried with a little bit of fresh herb, sea salt, and Old Bay. We open them up for you at the table like this so you can get the aroma in your face right when you open, keeps them nice and warm, and it's really exciting. And we've served it here with a really nice IPA from Sand City up in Northport.